Good morning, friends. It's 7:30 in the morning. We are up early because Carlos has a consultation with a endodontist, which is basically a dentist, wow, good morning, which is basically a dentist that specializes in internal, like, dental problems. As you guys know, 2 weeks ago, he started having pain in one of his tooth right here, like the tooth right here at the bottom. And we went to our family dentist. Dr. Shu took an x-ray and said, there's definitely an infection in one of them. We don't know if it's a root canal. We don't know if the endodontist is going to go in from behind the veneer, or we're going to have to pop the veneer out, clean it up, pop the veneer back, which requires us to go all the way back to LA to get new veneers, which would be such a crazy time because we would have to go to LA twice. The first time to get a temporary veneer and then the second time to get the permanent. Or there's a chance that the endodontist will pop this tooth out completely and do a implant or a crown. So we've been anxious for this consultation for the last 2 weeks. Hopefully the results are something easy and not too expensive as well. We will see, but that's why we're up early, because 8 o'clock in the morning is the appointment and I'm not a morning person. You guys know that. I think when I get home, I'm probably gonna nap. I'm not gonna lie to you. I wanna eat that one. Where is it? My car is clean, I promise. I'm getting it, okay? Because food is expensive these days. Oh! I'm stupid. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I know it might be gross to some of you, but I'm eating it, okay? I'm sorry. Food is food. It's expensive out there. Times are hard. The economy is crazy. I'm eating the food, okay? So let's just get over that. What an eventful week and day it's been. Clearly, I am not at home right now. I woke up this morning at like 6:30, 7 o'clock, went to the consultation with Carlos. Ooh, let me give you an update on what's going on with Carlos. Okay, so one, we're still waiting for a surgery date for this freaking gallbladder. We're meeting with a gallbladder surgeon in 2 weeks, and hopefully we're walking out of that office with a surgery date for him. And hopefully it's in April and not in June or July or August. Hopefully it's in April. I'll even take May. I would love to just get it removed because Carlos would just feel so much better. So that's what's going on with the gallbladder. So far, update for him, he's been doing pretty well. He's been feeling really healthy. Because of this whole situation, he has changed his diet. He's changed basically his entire life. He has dropped 30 pounds in the last, I would say, 4 months. And he is feeling great. He hasn't had a gallbladder attack in 2 weeks. We have found that the remedy that helps the most with the gallbladder attack is 2 Tylenols, 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar with the mother, mixed with organic 100% apple juice, not the one from concentrate, just organic apple juice. And it seems that the pain goes away within like 30 minutes. Regardless, he's been just so, so good. And so we've been monitoring that. Now let's talk about his teeth. About 2 weeks ago, Carlos started feeling pain right there. And the verdict is he's gonna need another root canal. So basically, the endodontist said that he can't really figure out what is going on until he goes in there. But it does seem like it's a root canal issue. So regardless, he's gonna have to open it up anyways. So as of right now, we don't really have an answer yet until he goes in and opens up the tooth, which we have scheduled for 2 weeks from now. So he's gonna get that done. And then after that, we will figure out if he's gonna need an implant or a crown or a bridge, or his teeth will be savable and we just need to go get another veneer, which requires us to go all the way to LA to Dr. Gabe to get another new veneer for that tooth, because Carlos is covered under Dr. Gabe's dental until July, because he covers the first 2 years. If you like break a veneer or anything, you get it replaced for free. So we're gonna take advantage of the free. That is what is going on. aside from that, all four boys went and got a health checkup this week. As I'm telling you right now, I've been so busy this week. I have not picked up the camera. I'm going to be so busy the next few weeks as well. There's just so many things going on in work and personal. So this week, all four dogs went and got their annual checkup and they are healthy. Nothing is going on. Old man's heart murmur is still a 4 out of 6. It has not gotten worse. That's all I can be grateful for. I'm very, very happy. Happy that he is the same. Old man has dropped tremendous amount of weight. He used to be 28 pounds and now he's 21 pounds. So over the last 2 years, he's dropped a lot of weight. And so we did a urine test and a blood test to see if there's like any internal organ failure or anything. There is not, so that's good. His organs are healthy. Blood test was completely healthy and normal. His urine test showed a little bacteria, which showed it could be a UTI coming in. So he's on antibiotics right now. His right eye is 100% blind. That was confirmed, I think, a year and a half ago. But yeah, his right eye is 100% blind. He can't see out of it. And his other eye, I was concerned because I was like, okay, is the other eye going bad too? And the vet said that his other eye is actually 100% good. There is no sign of it going bad at all. So he's got one great 100% working eye. Cooper needs to get some teeth cleaning. So we have that scheduled for next week. Rocky, I don't know how I feel about teeth cleaning for Rocky yet. She said that he pretty much can go on without teeth cleaning just because he's a senior and he's old. I also am trying to avoid putting him under at any cost. I know that they can fix the blind eye, but I'm just like, I don't want to put him under because he's got that heart murmur and that would put me under a lot of stress and I don't want to put his body through a lot of stress if he's happy the way he is. So I'll just keep an eye on him and see what's going on there. Casper has been good. He had like a intense itching situation. Turns out it's like a dermatitis issue. So he's on medication right now. And Riley so far is good. Riley is very good. Nothing is going on with Riley. He's just our big boy. But that is what's going on. I am also healthy. I seem to be the healthiest one in this house right now. So I'm keeping my together and taking care of my boys, my human one and my dog ones. Everything is good so far. I'm just taking it day by day, week by week, and not worrying too much. But I will tell you, if you guys got a chance to look at my calendar for March, it is wild.
I don't know if you guys can see, but it's raining so much. I've been stuck in my car for like the last 20 minutes just sitting here talking to Michelle on the phone.
But we are now at HomeGoods and I hope that I can find some cute stuff. For a while, HomeGoods was having like Easter vibes because Easter's coming up. So we're seeing a lot of rabbits, a lot of bunnies, a lot of eggs and flowers. So I want to see what's new here. And then I think we'll walk over to TJ Maxx because what else do you want to do on a rainy day? And I haven't been to TJ Maxx in a very long time. I want to see if they have some cute accessories.
I just saw this Buddha statue and I thought it was so pretty. I called my mom, but she said that she ran out of room because I keep buying her so many at HomeGoods. But look how pretty this one is, friends. I love the shiny finish on it. And Buddha looks so beautiful. It's going for $25, which is really pretty too. Or $25, which is pretty good too. And the statue is beautiful, but my mom doesn't need it. It's looking like I don't see a lot of, oh my God, there's a good luck Buddha over there. It's looking like we have a lot of florals for spring. I think Easter decor might be a little bit over, but let's see. No one is at HomeGoods today. Oh my God, it's a Thursday night, almost at closing. I think there's like another hour until closing. This is a good luck Buddha. How beautiful. It's really giving spring, like a lot of spring vibes, a lot of flowers. Oh, these are pretty. Remy loves blue hydrangeas. Oh my God, they feel so real. Oh my God, wait a minute. Wait, these feel so freaking real. They're not paper. It's like a really soft material. Oh my God, I love lemons. You have to find the right ones because sometimes I feel like lemons can look tacky and cheap. So you have to like find the right ones. Like these leaves are really nice. Oh my God, these would be so cute to hang. I have always adored these. Like at the front patio or the backyard, these would be so cute. I think one of my favorite things to do is like going on alone dates and alone time. Like I love getting my alone time and just like being with myself. And I love going to HomeGoods and just like looking at things. I don't always buy stuff. I just like to look. Like their glassware here is so good. Oh my God. How much is this? Look, you guys. There's 4, but how much? Oh my gosh. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. You always have to. Oh, $25 for 4. I want to take them out and see if they're cute. do you like this? You said you were looking for some. Hang on, give it a minute.
No, thank you.
There's a lot.
It's okay, mom. I decided I'm gonna go get the cream bear one.
There's these here, the squares. Hang on, just hang on. Before we get off, you know? I think that's it today. I don't see anything
today,
else.
Today, sales of the day.
That's it for today. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
I love looking at aprons. I have this one at home. I saw this floral one and I got interested. I don't know if they have good. Oh, this one's cute. So far, my cart is empty because I don't really need anything. I'm just looking. How cute is this blanket? It has flowers on it. How cute is that, friends? Do you guys see? Look at the flowers on the blanket. I love that. That little detail is cute. Ooh, this looks nice. Ooh, that feels like that Barefoot Dreams blanket. Oh my god, that's so cozy. And it's really thick too. This is really nice. I don't know about the pattern. It's going for $25, but I don't need it. Moving on. This is like kind of cute, but kind of not cute. Ooh, so many blankets out. Literally no one's here today. It's so nice. I'm freaking out. I don't need this, but look how beautiful this outdoor patio set is. I think it's by the Martha Stewart line, but look at this detail, you guys. There's two chairs here, a table, and then a long bench. You could also buy these two. This is not part of the collection, but they just happen to match this whole set. And it comes with that table. Oh my god, look at this. That is so freaking pretty. Okay, this is what I have so far. Found these really good leashes. We actually have this at home in blue. And I found three red ones for the littles. And I've been looking for this thick leash. It's 6 feet and it's really thick and good quality. I grab the little some. Now I'm looking at mirrors. As you guys know, we're redoing our walk-in closet this spring. And I'm so excited. I'm gonna look for a mirror. I'll show you the design once I start showing you the closet. I was like, why not just take a look and see if they have anything here. This is so cute though. HomeGoods has really good stuff right now. As you guys know, Michelle and I love looking and collecting cards, any cards, and we have a collection because you never know when you need cards. And there have been so many situations where we don't even have to buy any because we went out and just like had a whole collection. My sister-in-law's birthday is coming up and she has this like obsession with sharks and she loves them so much. And I found this card at HomeGoods for $2.99. It's originally $4. It has a shark on it. Look how cool that is. I'm so excited. That was such a good find. And then I found this one that's really cute. It says, hey, birthday bud. And it has a bunch of dogs on it. Is it too bright? Let me adjust real quick. Oh, there you go. You can see it way better now. It says, hey, birthday bud. So cool. Also $2.99. Let me show you the shark one again in case you didn't see it earlier. She's gonna love this. I'm so excited. And then I found this dinosaur one that says, happy birthday. They're all $2.99. There's like a bunch here. There's so many. Like, how cute is this one? Oh, I love this one. Oh, sending you hedgehogs. Yeah. That's so cute. I got the goods. Let's walk over to TJ Maxx. Found these earrings. They're so cute. Oh, you guys can see them. Let's see if I can zoom in. They're so cute. They're by Rachel Zoe. And they're going for like $14.99. I'm going to put them in my car. I don't know if I need them. Just for now. I'm here at the robe section. And they have a juicy couture robe. I love robes. So I'm going to look at these real quick to see what they have at TJ Maxx. Oh my god. Oh my god. Pink juicy. Oh my god, I'm freaking out, you guys. Pink juicy sweatpants. Oh my god, I'm getting these. Oh my god, is there one for Michelle? I have to get one for Michelle. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, it's a robe. I thought it was a top. I need oxygen. I can't believe it. Oh my god. Getting Michelle one too. And I'm gonna look at robes. Oh my god, she's gonna freak out. Also, it's originally, these juicy sweatpants are originally $36 and I'm getting them for $12.99. Look, $12.99. They're originally $36. I'm getting them for $12.99. Oh my god, I'm freaking out.
I'm at Target and it is so loud in here, so I have to speak up a little bit more. Usually I'm whispering out in public. I went back to grab these. I saw them the other day when we went to Target together and I could not resist. They're in the bathroom section and it's so beautiful. It's like this stone material with these ridges on. And then I also grabbed this tray. This bathroom tray is so beautiful. It's going for $6 and I think it's so beautiful in the bathroom or in your office, you guys, or your beauty desk, anything. This is so pretty for $6. I've never heard the music this loud at Target before. It is so loud. Okay, so Mario, you guys know Mario, my handyman, but also my contractor. He's an angel. He's amazing. His birthday is in a few days, and I'm actually having him over on Friday because he's gonna help install something for the studio. So I wanted to surprise him with a birthday present and a little cupcake so we can celebrate his birthday a little early. So I'm debating if I should do a birthday gift basket or gift cards. I got a package from Fenty Skin and Fenty Beauty, and I am obsessed, you guys. I'm a huge fan of their gloss bombs. These are the best lip glosses ever. If you guys saw my lip gloss collection, you know that I literally collect them. They are so, so good. They just came out with a new color. It's this one right here that you're seeing. It's called Fuchsia Flex. And the funny thing is, I love it so much, I just bought it at Sephora. So now that I got this in PR, I'm gonna return this to Sephora. But that's how much I love it. I love Fenty so much. These are their lip glosses, which I love. They're actually lip oils. I love them as well. I think this one is new, the melon. I have the Barbados cherry and then these plush puddings. Put in. They're like lip mask. I haven't tried these yet, but I definitely could use them on my lips. But you guys, I love them so much. Thank you so much to Fenty Skin and Fenty Beauty for sending this over. I appreciate it so much. I love everything here. See, I'm not kidding with you guys. I might have a little obsession with Fenty Beauty. Literally so good. I would say like this one's my favorite. It's been my favorite for years. It's called Fenty Glow. If you guys are looking to try it for the first time, Fenty Glow alone on top of a liner or even on top of lipstick or any liquid lip gloss is so good. It will never do you wrong. It's probably the best lip gloss ever. It's so shiny. It's beautiful. It's got a nice color to it, but it's not opaque where it's like annoying. It's not sticky. It is just so nice. I also have the Fenty lip gloss here that I bought a few months ago, but I literally collect them and I have backups because I always have this fear of something that I love going out of stock. Aside from the juicy sweatpants that I got at TJ Maxx, I found these. It was a pack of, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 kitchen towels for $12.99. And I just love this print. I love this green color. And I love that this is like really pretty, but it's not too Easter. I feel like you can use this year round, especially spring and summer. It's adorable. It has little bunnies and florals. And then you get this plaid pattern right here. And then you get a solid, and then you get another one with the design. And these are really nice to have in the kitchen. I love them so much. Such a good find.
I want to show you a few things that I got at Target. I last minute saw this and I was like, oh my goodness, I have to share this with you guys. So this is from Target's like organizational brand called Brightroom. I'm sure you guys have seen them. It's this, basically it's called a stackable 3-drawer slide out bin. And it's really good quality. As you guys can tell, it's nice, thick, plastic. It's really thick and very sturdy. This is plastic, right? Or is it acrylic? I think it's acrylic. Plastic or acrylic. Usually people would use this for like the office to organize paperwork. You can organize pencils. You can even just be creative and organize jewelry, organize makeup brushes. You can organize makeup products. If you do arts and crafts, you can organize arts and crafts, paintbrushes, colored pencils. There's so many ways you can use this to organize. So when I looked at it, I was like, that's gotta be like $25 or $30 because the quality is just so good and it's really big. I mean, just to give you guys an idea, this is how big it is. So I was like, you know, it just seems like a good price would be $25-$30. It's $15. I was very surprised when it rung up to be $15. This is what it looks like here. There's a little inspiration photo. If you guys can see, they use it as like an office supply. I am really excited for this. I feel like this can be a flexible way to organize so many things. And I just wanted to share it with you because I feel like this is so convenient. I'm going to link it down below so you guys can check it out if you're interested. Oh my God. And I found this in the basket organizational bins section next to the laundry section. If you see this, please, please, please get it. I feel like it's such a good find. Let me take this off so I can actually show you how functional it is. Here you go. So these are the drawers here. This is just the scraps. That's just for packaging. Let me take this out and show you guys. So these are the drawers. They're pretty big, you guys. That is huge. You can organize so many things. Oh, this is such a good find for 15 bucks. The size, the quality, being able to be versatile with it. It's so good. To give you an idea, it's about 13 inches by 13 inches by 8 inches. So good. So it's really big. 12 inches is a roller, just to give you an idea. The reason that I even went out today is because Mario, our contractor, you guys know him. I always have his information down below in the description bar. His birthday's coming up and he's actually coming this Friday to build an IKEA system and help me out with the studio, but he's so good. If you guys are looking for someone to renovate your house, if you have an idea for a bedroom or a bathroom, he can do everything. If you have anything broken in your house, he will come and fix it. He did all of our flooring in our house. He did our bathrooms, our laundry room, our pantry. He is amazing. And his wife Raquel does hair and she is bomb. And they are such good people, genuine people. The prices are reasonable and they just genuinely care about you. And I just love them so much. They've become such amazing friends of ours. But yeah, check out Mario. Mario's amazing. He will travel to you guys. He's the sweetest. If you guys have met him, you know. So his birthday's coming up. I thought I would make him a little gift basket. I found this little basket in the Target's dollar section for $3. And what I'm gonna do is I got a bunch of gift cards. So I got gas gift cards. Who doesn't love gas gift cards? And then I got Amazon gift cards. He obviously is contractor, so I got him Home Depot gift cards, Lowe's gift cards. I got him 10 gift cards. It's a lot. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stuff this with tissue paper and do a little gift card garden. It's gonna be so cute. I'm gonna do that in the next video. So if you guys are interested in doing that with me, check out the next vlog. That'll be really fun to do. I think I'm gonna do this tomorrow. So that'll be in the next video. And then I got a bunch of these because we're celebrating my sister-in-law and my niece's birthday this weekend as well. We got a bunch of good stuff at Target, which I think I'm gonna do a short little video on Instagram showing it. So you guys will see it. You guys will see it. It's been a little bit since we've done an Amazon haul of things that I've got. So let's open these together. First and foremost, I got this from Amazon. Everything from Amazon, actually. Yeah, nothing here is not from Amazon. There's one thing that I can't show you because it's a birthday present for a friend, and that friend happens to watch the vlogs, religiously. So we cannot, we shall not. Okay, this is the first thing I got from Amazon. I don't know if you guys know this. Amazon has these, and they're kind of just a cute little thing to get. Okay, they're insurance and registration document envelopes. Don't laugh at me, you guys. It's really cool because it looks like this. And then you open it up and you can put your insurance and registration, insurance on one side, registration on the other side, and you have it organized. It comes in multiple colors. I get the red because I'm just thinking about it. And if I were to ever get pulled over, I would be panicking. And I don't want to think about where my insurance and registration is. So I want things in bright colors so I can easily grab it, give it to the police officer. He opens it up. And it's all right here. These are really nice. It comes in a pack of two. So I got Carlos and I one for each of our cars. But yeah, if you didn't know, now you know. If you guys remember in the last vlog, I was looking for new silverware. The ones that we have are black. And I bought those back in 2021 when we first bought this house, when we first moved in. One thing that I've learned about black silverware or black utensils is that obviously after using them and washing them, they scratch up, okay? So we're not gonna do black ever again. We're also not gonna do gold. We're not gonna do color. I just want the nice silverware color. I really wanted stainless steel. I wanted to get them from Crate and Barrel and William and Sonoma, but I could just not justify the price. It was going for a set of 20 for $150, $200. It was really expensive. So until then, I got this whole pack for $24 off of Amazon, and I'm really excited about them. However, if they're not good quality, I'm returning them. And Oh, they're kind of ugly. Wait, I'm not gonna, It had really good reviews. It just feels old. I don't know. If you guys are into like silverware stuff, how do you feel about this? I got it because like the thinness of it was kind of modern and cute. Like you see how thin everything is? To do this like makeup, you see how thin? Like I thought that was kind of sexy, but this is really important to me, okay? Because I host a lot, and so I want people to like have nice like silverware to eat with. Okay, my first thought is that it was kind of ugly, but I feel like it's growing on me. It's very light, very thin. I'll think about it. I don't know how I feel about this. If you guys have any good recommendations for silverware that is not gonna get scratched and are pretty, please let me know. So it came with this fork, and it came with a longer fork as well. So long fork, short fork. It came with a small spoon, big spoon. It's 48 pieces, so it's like, it's a lot. It feeds 8 people, I believe. And then the cool thing about it that really sold me is that it came with, hi baby, it came with steak knives. Look at these steak knives that are all wrapped up. Steak knives are a plus. I love steak knives, and it also came with butter knives. I might actually keep these now that I'm thinking about it. I think my first impression of them are that they are ugly, but they're growing on me. I think it'll do. Let me look at the, maybe I should look some more and then we'll go from there. But I'm not against it. It's a good price to have, you know? Usually, Casper gets very, very anxious whenever I'm opening boxes. No, baby. I don't know where those lips have been. Now you're too excited. Usually he's very anxious when I'm opening boxes. Like he'll freak out, he'll run away, he'll hide. But I don't know why all of a sudden today he's in the mood. Okay, next and foremost. The next thing we're doing is, oh, I got a cake knife and server set. We've been cutting a lot of cakes. Oh my God, my heart just dropped down to my booty hole. My camera was about to fall off these boxes. You guys are on a box right now. So we've been cutting a lot of cakes in our household. We've been hosting a lot, and so I realized that I didn't have it, and I realized that I really wanted it, okay? It's not a necessity. It's one of those like 30-year-old homeowner things, okay? I don't have a reason for it. It's a vibe that you have to like, you know, if you get it, you get it. So I got this on Amazon, obviously. It wasn't that crazy. This is what I'm talking about. It's nice and shiny. It's a knife to cut. Oh, look, you can see yourself. Say hello. It's a knife that you can cut the cake, and then it comes with a little spatula so you can scoop the cake. So I got this whole set on Amazon. Very nice. I'm keeping that. Okay, this one I've been crazy excited for. This is the DJI Mic 2. The Mic 1 is very popular, but they just came out with the Mic 2. If you guys create a lot of content on YouTube, or you create a lot of short videos on TikTok or Instagram, and you're looking for really good audio, this mic is literally, everyone's talking about it, and the quality is just crazy good. It's the DJI Mic 2. I'll link it down below for you guys, but it looks like this. The reason that I got this is because I want a really good mic. Right now I'm using the Rode. I'm gonna be honest with you. I really liked the Rode when I had like one Rode mic in 2020, and I would go to restaurants and film mukbangs there. And then I got the Rode with the two mics. So then Michelle, who I always go out to eat with, she can have a mic and I can have a mic, but that one sucks. I don't like that quality. I got it a few months ago. I'm probably gonna end up selling it or something. The reason I got this one is because it comes with two mics and the sound quality is so bomb. They have a noise cancellation feature in this, so even when you're in like a really crowded place, it cancels out all the noise and you can only hear yourself. And the coolest part about this is that it comes inside this charging case. My Rode mic that I just recently bought, you have to like individually plug it into the outlet to charge. This one, everything is organized in this case, so you can charge both of your mics in here, and then this middle section, that's what you plug into your camera. And then also you can use it for the camera, or you can use it for your iPhone. So if you're making short videos with your iPhone, you can plug it directly into your iPhone and use that and have bomb audio. So I'm so hype about this, you guys. I've been wanting it for so long. It's definitely something very expensive, but this is like obviously my job and what I do, and this is gonna make, I feel like, my mukbang videos at the restaurants way, way better. And I'm hoping to try it out next week. So I've been so excited about this. I'm gonna open it up and try it out. I might try it out this weekend, actually. Kind of silly, but I got this damp duster from Scrub Daddy, and the reason I got this was because I saw a TikTok of this lady. She wet it and she cleaned her appliances like her oven and her dishwasher and her fridge, and all of the handprints and all the scratches came off and it was so shiny. So I'm trying this for the first time. I'll let you guys know how it works out. Okay, let's see what's in this one. Oh, I got a Ring doorbell camera from Amazon. I'm actually installing this at my mom's house. It's about time that my mom gets a doorbell camera. I'm actually going down to her house next weekend to install that. And then we're also switching out a pendant light that she has in her house. So I got some light bulbs for her because they were just cheaper on Amazon. All right, I'm moving you because I have to open this box, and that's what you were sitting on. Oh, shoot, that was quick. Well, damn. I swear I ordered this 2 nights ago. Oh my God, that was like really fast shipping. That's why I was like confused opening this, because I was like, wait a minute, this doesn't look like an Amazon box. Okay, so this is my current favorite obsession. This is the Mama's Chili Oil. So it's by this brand named, ooh, I just forgot how to pronounce it, Kaidong? Oh, I'm probably saying it wrong. Okay, so if you guys watch a lot of food content on TikTok, on Instagram, on YouTube, then you know Tiffy. Tiffy is such a sweet person. I love her dearly. She just came out with a cookbook that's actually in my kitchen right now. Tiffy also makes cooking content. So she makes a lot of short form content with like quick recipes. She has her book that is the best selling book right now. Congrats, Tiffy. That is such an amazing thing. And then she's got a YouTube channel where she cooks for her husband. She just bought her house. Her house is gorgeous. She does like what I eat in a week. She does like what I cook for my husband in a week. Her recipes are so easy to follow, and her filming is beautiful, and her videos are great, and she does it on shorts and Instagram. She's all over the place, okay? She recently just came out with her own company, which is so, so dope. She came out with her own noodles and then also chili oil. She sent this chili oil with the cookbook, and I tried it for the first time 2 nights ago. I loved it so much, I bought 3. I literally went on the website and bought 3. It came within 2 days. I cannot believe it. This is what it looks like here. I got a pack of 3 because the individuals were sold out. There were like 2 other flavors. This is so good. I cannot wait to do like hot pot or Korean barbecue and dip my meat in this. It's so good. Tiffy, if you're watching, sometimes she watches the vlogs. Tiffy, if you're watching, congrats. This is amazing. I'm obsessed. And thank you so much for the fast shipping. I literally ordered it 2 nights ago. I'm like shocked. And it's packaged very well. Like whoever invented this packaging is genius, because this is like a thick glass jar and this did not break. I love the packaging, but more importantly, I love the flavors. And also the heat, it's like got a nice kick to it. It's spicy, I will say. It's spicy, but oh, I can't wait. We're having Korean barbecue and hot pot soon, and I'm gonna be all over this. I don't think I can show this one because it's for a birthday and that person watches the videos. Wow, sometimes I hate Amazon. Dude, I ordered this thing and they literally didn't give a shit about it, and it's all bent. I'm so bummed. I think I can show you guys, but it's literally an envelope, and instead of doing it this way, they like did it like this, so now the whole thing is bent. Okay, whatever. Hopefully nothing's ruined. Ugh, I'm bummed. I feel like they just don't care. They just like throw it in. Oh, I got some vitamins. This is Nature-Wise Vitamin D3. I found this on Amazon, of course, and it had crazy reviews. We're looking for a good vitamin, so this is vitamin D3, but this had crazy reviews. Like, I think it had like really high thousands. Like, we're talking like 80,000 or something. And so I wanted to recommend this to you guys to try with me. I'm trying this for the first time. And then I also have fish oil. I was looking for a fish oil that didn't taste like ass and was a good price. And this one had really, really good reviews. Also, it's like cheaper to buy vitamins on Amazon. However, I heard it's really cheap to buy vitamins at Costco or Sam's Club. So that is my next stop. I just urgently needed these ASAP. So I went with the Amazon route, but this one had really good reviews. I'll go ahead and link these down below if you guys are interested. I know we're all on our little health kick and like talking about vitamins and stuff. This is fish oil and I got it on Amazon. I want to try this out. There we go. I know that Care Of also has vitamins that you can put in a pack and like have everything in one pack. But sometimes if you run out of that and you're waiting for that, these are great options to have as well. Also check out Care Of. There are so many different outlets that you can get your forms of vitamins that are curated for you and what's good for you. And you can have the convenience of having it at your door. But these are good as well. And honestly, the number one reason why I got these is because Carlos needs them. He needs vitamin D3. surgery, which is what his doctor said, and then fish oil, which I'm kind of nervous about this fish oil because his doctor said that he needs omega-3, and this is kind of the only way to take omega-3. I'm trying to look for like a gummy form. If you guys know Carlos, he hates fish. Like, he will throw up with the smell of fish or the taste of fish. So I heard that these are good to swallow. Like, they don't taste like fish, but yeah, we'll see. And it only took me years to buy this. All of my wooden spoons have either cracked or they have been scratched up, and I have not bought wooden spoons in the last 2 years, and it was time for a restock. So I got these wooden spoons from Amazon. Instead of dark wood, I opted for like this nice oak wood, which I think is so much prettier than the dark wood. But I'll link these down below because you guys always ask about my wooden spoons in my mukbangs or when I'm cooking or eating. And they're really, really nice. One thing that I suggest is to not put these in the dishwasher because that's how I scratch all of mine. And by the time I realized, it was just too late. So I've been kind of using them up until they literally look like they're dying. And after 2 years, I am buying new ones. I went for this nice color here. I absolutely love it. And I love these for soup because I don't like to eat really hot things. It's not enjoyable to me. So whenever I eat soup, I like these because they don't burn my mouth. Whenever I eat soup and like people offer like silverware, it's so hard to eat because the silverware obviously gets really hot. So I like eating this with like really hot soup. But it comes in a pack of 6. So you get 6 of the spoons. I think there's other colors. I'll link these down below for you guys because I know you're really interested in these. I am going to end this vlog here because I have a few things to do and I feel like the rest of the night is really not that interesting. I'm going to break down these boxes, put things away. Our house is a mess. We're having family over this weekend for 2 birthday celebrations. It's gonna be so fun. I have my studio renovation. I have the closet walk-in closet renovation coming up. We have a little office renovation. Things are happening and I'm really, really excited to share those vlogs with you guys. You know, we're switching up the house a little bit, okay? We haven't done it in a while. I'm really, really excited. I can't remember, but I feel like in 2023, we didn't renovate anything, right? I can't remember. I think 2023, I really just took a step back and I was like, okay, I'm happy we're with it, where things are now. But the beautiful part about living in your own house is you can do whatever you want with it. And after you live somewhere for a little bit, you start to realize what works and what doesn't and what you want to change. So if you can, then why not do it? But I'm really, really excited. They're not too crazy. Actually, the closet, obviously. It's going to be the biggest transformation, but we're not doing the closet until probably, I would say, like May. We just signed the contract, so we just ordered all of our materials for the closet, so that'll come in May. I think the first thing you guys are going to see, obviously, is the studio. That will be done this weekend, and then probably the office, my office, and the closet will be finished at the same time, so that'll probably be in May. But anywho, you guys, a lot of exciting things coming up, a lot of busy things coming up, and just pray that Carlos can get into a surgery for his gallbladder soon. I'm so, so anxious and excited for that. And I know he just wants to get it over with as well. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. I know today was just like a one day vlog. Usually I vlog for like 3 days and we hang out and it feels like forever. And I love it so much. Thank you for understanding that life is wild right now. I will see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to leave a comment down below. Subscribe to this channel, to my mukbang channel. And I also want to say thank you so much to everyone who messaged me, who texted me in my personal life, who left a comment in the previous video where I shared a little bit of my emotions about my mom and where I feel like I am right now in life. It was so amazing and so nice. I was so grateful to open up my YouTube and read all of your wonderful comments. Your words really made me feel so comfortable. I felt like I was a part of something very personal in your life as well. And a lot of you guys really did help me kind of either change my perspective on the way I was thinking about life or really helped me figure out how I can deal with my emotions. So I just wanted to say I appreciate it so much for taking the time out to leave those wonderful comments. I read every single one of them and I just appreciate you guys so much. I feel like my vlogs are like an online diary and I really don't have a filter with how I feel. I think it's really important in life in general to just let yourself feel things and let yourself like be emotional and feel things and learn and grow and blossom through everything that you go through, good or bad. And I never want my vlogs to like feel not authentic or unnatural or too polished. Like, this is real life, you know? Sometimes that can be really scary to open up to the internet and the world because there are so many people out there to judge you. And I feel like sometimes when I'm talking about something or I'm sharing how I feel, I have to consider so many angles and consider so many people's opinions. At the end of the day, I just have to remind myself that there's only me and this is just how I feel. I love you guys. I will see you guys at the end of this weekend. So I hope you have a great weekend. Oh my God, you just scared the shit out of me.